Good morning. Today is the 16th of July, and our text for today is Romans chapter 8, verse 34. Who is the one who condemns? Christ is the one who died, and more than that, who was raised, who is also at the right hand of God, who also intercedes for us. This is our fourth question on these five questions at the end of Romans chapter 8. Paul is using them to show us the power of God to redeem us, the power of God that God is operating to save us. And this is the fourth question. Who is the one who condemns? There is no condemnation, he said in the beginning of this chapter, in the verse 1, for those who are in Christ Jesus. And we see that our salvation here is totally dependent on the work of the Lord on the cross. And that's what he's going to say. Christ is the one who died. And more than that, who was raised, who also is at the right hand of the Father and intercedes for us. So we have here his death, his resurrection, his ascension, and his intercession. So the complete work of Christ from the beginning to the end. Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. But some things, including some people as well, some like the devil, would try to condemn us. And John says that our heart sometimes tries to condemn us. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 20, if our hearts condemn us, we know that God is greater than our hearts and he knows everything. Sometimes we ourselves will try to condemn us. Our hearts do, but God is greater than that. And so Christ, in his work on the cross, has taken away our sins. He has actually died for our sins. That's what Galatians says. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13 says, Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who is hung on a pole, on a tree. So that comes from the Old Testament, that quotation, that shows that everyone who is hung on a tree, on a pole, is cursed. So Jesus became curse for you. The curse that should fall on you to condemn you, it has fallen on him. He has taken on your curse. Can you imagine what it is to take on everyone's curse? He took your curse, my curse, the curse of the whole world on him. It fell on him. And so he died on a tree, on a cross for us, because he became a curse for us. The Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his power. By his powerful word, after he had provided purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. And that comes from Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3. Now, that's how the book of Hebrews starts. It starts with seven works of Christ, from creation to intercession. The same one who created the universe in Hebrews chapter 1 is the one who now intercedes for us. A complete, and it being seven, it shows that it is complete, a complete work from the beginning to eternity. From eternity to eternity. That's Christ. It's very important for us to be reminded every day that the gospel is about Jesus Christ and his ministry and his work of salvation, his work of intercession. It doesn't end with him going up into heaven, because we might think that he's gone up to heaven and we're waiting for him to come back to take us, and so we'll be with him forever. But in between, he is interceding for us. The ministry of the Christ, the eternal Christ, is here by his spirit. We are not on his own. He said, I will send my spirit. And Paul in the book, in the same book, book of Romans, chapter 8, says that we have the spirit of Christ in us. Day after day, every priest stands and performs his religious duties again and again. He offers the same sacrifice, which can never take away sins. That's the problem with religion. It cannot take away sins. And he's talking about the priests in the Old Testament. And some people still thought that they could use religion to be set free from sin. But there is no way you can be set free from sin by using religion. You need the work of the eternal Christ. Nobody can condemn you because God is interceding for you in the person of his Son. That's the secret here. That's what he's saying here. There is no condemnation because the same Christ who died, who raised again, and who went into heaven, is at the right hand of the Father and is interceding for you. And finally, I would like to read in 1 John chapter 2, verse 1, My dear children, I write this to you so that you will not sin. But if anybody does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He's our advocate. He's not saying that you should sin anyway because Christ is going to redeem us and save us and save you and pardon you and forgive you. But he's saying, if you sin, you have an advocate with the Father. And that's Jesus Christ, the righteous one. God bless you.